there are some of you today and you've been feeling little spurts or windows of strength. There's something hindering you from serving God fully. There's sin holding you back, wrong relationships, addictions. And you've been having these experiences. Some of you, God's even giving you dreams where you have a dream and you wake up and you feel like, okay, I'm getting out. Okay, I'm leaving this behind me. And you have this strength welling up inside of you. And I just want to tell you that's a work of the Lord. And that's the Holy Spirit giving you the moment to obey Him. Because when He convicts your heart, obey in that moment. Because that little window of strength that you're getting, it is what you need to make up your mind to obey God. And when you put your whole heart, when you put your mind, make it up that you're going to obey God, that little window of strength, once you turn around and repent and go towards what you know is obedience before God, He will rescue you from whatever that thing is. You will be surprised at the way God will make for you to get out, whether it's addictions, wrong relationships, just anything you make an idol, adjustments in your life that you need to make to where you know it's putting God first, things you need to let go of. That window of strength is a life or death situation for some of you. And I just want to give a warning that some of you, I'm not telling you to turn and seek God because life's going to be super easy and you're going to, you know, get goosebumps and everything's going to be fine. I'm asking you to turn away from your sin and go to God because your life is at risk. The enemy would want to sift you out. The enemy would want to kill you prematurely. I've seen it all around me. I've had death and destruction around me where I've been interceding for people. I've interceded for people with tears and I've warned people and they die right before me. It is serious in these days. The spiritual warfare that's been unleashed upon this nation is like never before. And some of you, you're playing with fire. And it seems like a small thing, the sin in your life, the hindrances you're holding on to. It seems like a small thing and that God will overlook it. No, the enemy is looking for holes in our armor so he can take us out and destroy us because he doesn't want a remnant upon the earth to get souls for his name. He doesn't want a people rising up in strength and holiness. Because if we do rise up, if we do get right with God, He is going to be in trouble. Because there are some of us who are just sick of being hindered, sick of being oppressed, and we're rising up. And I want you to be in that number because the enemy is after your soul. He's after your life. He's after the life of your children. There's some of you that there's generational curses. And if you would turn and obey God, He would heal you and your family. And those things that seem to be passed on, it would stop with you. And some of us need to break down the altars that our families have set up of sin, old altars, and just build an altar to Christ and say, no more compromise. No more falling into those things that feel so familiar to me, even though I know it's wrong, God. Just overlook it. It's not a time for God to overlook anything because Satan is looking for a hole in your armor so that he can put a hook in and take you out. The days are serious right now. No more can we just compromise and just get by. The onslaught of darkness is great. And so the holiness in our life needs to be great to combat it because it's our only hope. Obedience to God, being right with Him, the power of God, the wisdom of God, the Holy Spirit leading us into truth. That is our only hope right now in this world. It's going to get worse. And I want to just encourage you, if you're down today, if you're stuck in addictions, if you're backslidden, get up. Because if you don't get up soon, there might not be any getting up. The enemy might take your life. And I know people don't like to talk like this. They say it's doom and gloom, but I've seen it all around me. I've seen people make the decision not to heed a warning and they die. They die horribly. And I just want to tell you, you don't have to give yourself away to the enemy in any area of your life. Whatever you're struggling with, reach out to people who you know walk in obedience to God. People who know how to pray. So important. Find some people who know how to pray that you can call on and they can pray you through when you feel weak. Okay? God bless you. Have a beautiful day.